Hi, Adam here with Inspired LED. Today, I will demonstrate our brand new RGB solderless connector system using flexible RGB strips. At first, this system may look difficult to install, but after this video, you will see just how easy it is. We will begin by going through the steps on how to connectorize and terminate to a flexible RGB strip. Starting with your RGB strip, cut along the copper ovals for the desired length. For this demonstration, we are using a 30 LED per meter RGB strip. Cut points are every 4 inches. Next, we are going to add a solderless connector to the end of our RGB strip. If you look closely at your connector, you will see a locking cap, a flexible LED strip channel, and 4 input terminals. Take the end of the flexible RGB strip, peel the 3M adhesive located on the back, and insert it into the LED strip channel. Close your connector until you hear a snap. Sometimes these connectors can be a little tricky to close. Using a small tool like a screwdriver proves to be extremely helpful in locking the bridge in place. You'll notice there are 4 input terminals on your connector. These terminals are where you are going to terminate your 4 conductor cable. The 4 conductor cable you'll be using is a 22 gauge class 2 in-wall rated cable. We now need to strip this cable and expose the leads behind the outer cable sleeve. Using a pair of Klein cable strippers from Home Depot is the best tool to use when stripping our 4 conductor cable. Take the pair of cable strippers and strip the sleeve off your cable. The 16 gauge cable sheath stripping hole on your strippers is the perfect size when removing the outer sleeve of the 4 conductor cable. After removing the outer sleeve, you will expose your 4 leads that will terminate to your solderless RGB connector. You'll notice that each lead is a different color. There is black, red, green, and blue. The black lead indicates power, also known as the positive polarity. The other 3 leads are jacketed in the colors of the signal that will be transmitted into your RGB strip. The red sleeve carries the red signal, the green sleeve carries the green signal, and the blue sleeve carries the blue signal. Before we strip these wires, we need to make sure that 1, we strip enough for the cable to terminate to the connector properly, and 2, that we terminate the correct color to the correct terminal. There is an easy way to figure out how much cable you'll need to strip. Taking a look at your connector, there is a line on each connector that shows you where the inserted wire is going to stop. You'll need to strip about a quarter of an inch off each lead to ensure that the leads make full contact with each terminal input. Now strip each lead a quarter of an inch using your Klein cable strippers. Now you are going to terminate your cable leads into your solderless connector. Terminating your 4 conductor cable to the RGB connector is an extremely important step in this demonstration. Making sure black goes to positive, green goes to green, red goes to red, and blue goes to blue. This may sound redundant, but please understand that making sure these cables match the color code of the flexible RGB strip is the most crucial step of installing this system. Having any of these wires not matching the correct leads could jeopardize the overall functionality of the system. When inserting the leads into the connector, you may have to wiggle them in there until you feel the connector bite the wire. In the event you insert the wrong lead into the wrong connector input, you can carefully remove the lead by wiggling the cable until you feel it unlock and remove the wire. Now, you will not always be able to remove the cable easily. You may end up removing the copper contact point of the connector when trying to remove the wire. If this does happen, simply remove the entire connector and replace it. Now that we have gone through how to connectorize and terminate our flexible RGB strip, we'll move on to how to tie it into an RGB controller to create a fully functioning system. The controller that we most often use is an RF controller with a handheld remote. Starting with the controller, you will notice that there are screw terminals on both sides of the device. The 4 screw terminals indicates your RGB output. These terminals are what's going to send the signal to your flexible RGB strip. You'll notice that there is a rectangular box that labels each output terminal. They are a little difficult to see, but if you look closely, you will see a plus for the positive, an R for the red, a G for the green, and a B for the blue. Now you will need to strip the adjacent end of the cable that we terminated to the flexible RGB strip. Use your Klein cable strippers to remove about an inch of the outer sleeve. Once the sleeve is removed, remove a quarter of an inch from the four leads just as you did when terminating to the RGB connector. Start by loosening the four output screw terminals using a small screwdriver. If you do not do this, your wires will not connect properly. We need to make sure the black goes to positive, the red goes to red, the green goes to green, and the blue goes to blue. All we are doing here is making sure that the colors of the controller base match the colors of the output leads that are tied to your RGB strip. Once your leads are matched to your controller, tighten your screw terminals using a small screwdriver. Looking at the controller base again, the adjacent side of the RGB output, you'll see two screw terminals. These two screw terminals are for connecting your 12 or 24 volt DC class 2 power source. Turn your controller over and you'll notice those two screw terminals are labeled with a plus and a minus sign. This indicates your positive and negative polarity. You'll notice that these screw terminals are pretty small. You'll need to make sure that your power input cable size is between 16 and 22 gauge. Take your power source and identify the positive and negative polarity. Once identified, you want to strip the power supply cables a quarter of an inch to securely lock into the terminals. Loosen the two input power terminals and match the polarity of your power input cables to the input terminals of the controller base and tighten the screws. The positive lead goes to the positive or plus terminal and your negative lead goes to the negative or minus terminal. If your 12 or 24 DC power source happens to have a 5.5 millimeter mini jack connector, you can simply plug that connector into the mini jack input on the RGB controller base. Now that all the necessary steps have been completed, we are ready to activate our RGB system. Turn on your power supply and your flexible RGB strip will light up. Use your handheld remote to change through various settings, colors, and light intensities. Your remote has a color wheel that allows you to choose specific colors, two buttons to increase or decrease light intensity, and a white setting button. There is also a button that allows you to choose from 15 pre-programmed settings. These settings include modes that twinkle, breathe, and change colors automatically. The great thing about these RGB controllers is that they are Wi-Fi compatible. By simply plugging in a Wi-Fi module, you are able to control the LED controller base from a smart device. And there you go. You now know all the necessary steps to cut, connectorize, and terminate an RF-controlled RGB LED system. It's that easy.